Thank you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Dr. Lulu Mimatul Ifada. I'm from Economic Faculty of Sultan Agung Islamic University, Semarang, Indonesia. And my position is lecturer. I'm going to present my article toward firm value based on capital structure. I can see many of you are well informed, but I want to explore more. Okay, introduction. The development of globalization and information technology has made competition in the business world increasingly fierce. This will make companies always required to have creativity and develop innovation to have high competitiveness. The company's primary goal is not to obtain maximum profit, but to maximize the firm value by increasing the prosperity of the owners or shareholders. Maximize firm value is considered more appropriate as a goal because it means the same as maximizing the present value of all profit received by shareholders in the future in the long term. The firm value is related to the stock price in the capital market. If the stock price in the capital market is high, it will make the firm value also increase the prosperity of the owner or shareholders. Therefore, the management need to pay attention to the factor that can affect the firm value so that it can increase as expected by owner of the company and ultimately prosper the shareholders. This show a research gap on the effect of profitability, liquidity, dividend policy, and capital structure on firm value. Okay, theoretical pecking order theory. This theory also said that companies prefer internal financing, such as from the company's operational result in return earnings, rather than external financing. This is this is not because the company has a low target debt ratio, but because the company doesn't need a fund from external parties. Signaling theory. Based on the signaling theory, the higher the profitability, liquidity, and dividend policy, which are considered capable of providing information to stakeholders with favorable prospect, will avoid the sale of share and seek any new capital needed in other ways, including the use of debt that exceed the target capital structure. Okay. Our hypothesis development, effect of profitability on capital structure. High profitability means that the company has sufficient capital to finance the company's operational activity. 2011 support the pecking order theory has a significant adverse effect on the company's capital structure. So the hypothesis one, profitability has a significant negative effect on the capital structure. The effect of profitability on firm value. The higher the profitability on the company will have a good performance in generating net income from its operational activity. Chrysostomo 2011 can have support the profitability has a significant positive effect on firm value. The third effect of liquidity on capital structure. Owino 2011 found that liquidity result had a negative effect on the company's capital structure. Companies with a high level of liquidity reflect that the company's internal fund the company's operational cost without having to rely on external fund. This is in line with the pecking order theory. Fourth, effect of liquidity on firm value. Liquidity means that the company can meet its short-term obligation. This is under the signaling theory that good liquidation will signal the market a positive response. So, hypothesis for liquidity has significant positive effect on firm value. Effect of capital structure on firm value. Capital is an essential aspect for every company because it directly influences the company's financial position. The capital structure is the key to managing the source of funds from the company's performance because by looking at the company structure, it can be seen whether or not the company's performance is good. Sauna 2011 explained that capital structure positively influences firm value. So, hypothesis 4, capital structure has a significant positive effect on firm value. 6, effect of dividend policy on firm value. Okay, a dividend policy can use the payout ratio indicator, a percentage of income that will be paid to shareholders as cash dividend. Increase and decrease in dividend can affect stock price. If dividend are increased, the company's stock price in the capital market will increase and vice versa. This is supported by signaling theory, where companies that have a dividend policy with a high dividend distribution will attract investors to invest in the company. So, hypothesis 6, have dividend policy has a significant positive on firm value. This is the methodology that the population in this study focus on companies include in the Jakarta Islamic Index because Syariah-based stock tend the increase to increase and develop rapidly. The purposive sampling method was used as a sampling technique. The sample used companies from 2016 until to 2019. The data use structural equation model. This is operational definition of variable profitability, liquidity, dividend policy, capital structure, and firm value. Okay, the result, hypothesis 1 is rejected. Hypothesis 2 is accepted, hypothesis 3 is accepted, hypothesis 4 is rejected, hypothesis 5 is accepted, hypothesis 6 is rejected, and capital structure cannot be a mediator, and capital structure cannot be a mediator between liquidity and firm value. Okay, our discussion and conclusion. The result of first hypothesis, that is, if the profitability is higher, the capital structure will also increase. The result of two hypothesis analysis, this means that the higher of the company's profitability will improve the company's image. This is because the company has a going concern and good prospect for the future. The result of the third hypothesis analysis, this happened because the company has benefited from more liquid equity and will be more motivated to use more of its capital than its long-term debt and the increasing level of liquidity. The result of the first hypothesis analysis, this happened because it is possible that its liquidity is high, more assets are not managed effectively by the company, so that it will affect the company profit, the company's profit, the end of the period. Okay. The result of the fifth hypothesis analysis, this means that the company's management can signal investor about the policy of using debt and the capital structure for the business expansion of the company. And the result of sixth hypothesis analysis, that this is possible because of spirit analysis from investor, where investor think that company managers are not sensitive to opportunities. The result of the seven hypothesis analysis, this means that companies that have a high level of profitability can improve the company reputation indirectly through the capital structure. Okay, and the result of the eighth hypothesis indicate that companies with a high level of liquidity will indirectly reduce the firm value through the capital structure. Thank you. This is the last of our presentation. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.